So my brothers and sisters in Christ, when we hear Jesus speaking in parables, we immediately understand what he is saying, and it's easy to follow him. When he starts, a man came down from Jerusalem and two thieves robbed him. We understand. It's a common experience. A man had two sons, and we understand. This is our family. But when we listen to Paul, Paul usually is always using big ideas, no? And sometimes it's more difficult to follow him. We have to make an effort. But it is good. Paul is giving us ideas to help us to understand our faith and how to live it in our daily life. One idea of Paul is that the church is a one body, and we are its members. And today, in the letter to the Corinthians, he's saying that we are his field, or a building. And this is helping us to understand that easily. We are part of this building, each one brick. Each one is one plant in the field of God. And then Paul is saying one more thing. He's saying we are not only the bricks in the building that God is building, but we are also co-worker, we are fellow worker of God. We are working with him. God needs us in the church. The church is not building itself. God is building the church through us. So each one of us is important to offer his life, his body, his himself to build the church. And it's good that we have these ideas from Paul that are helping us to elevate us, our way of thinking, you know, from our daily life. Because we are lost very easily, you know, in our passions, in our interest. And so we are divided, you know. The church should be one, but most of the time it's one divided church. And we are divided in group, in languages, in tribes and peoples, and group of prayers. And each one thinks to be better than others. No, we are the one with the charismatic one. With the charismatic means with one gift and more than the others. No, and so we can be divided so easily. So the idea that we are one building, one field, one body, is helping us to forget, you know, our differences, our opinions, our intelligence sometimes, and just to trust what God is doing through us. In the gospel is much more simple. We follow Jesus in his daily life, a daily life of a healer, a man helping the people to be better, to get better. And we are told at sunset, all these people were bringing sick people to him to be healed. And when daylight came, the crowd was already there. So you see, evening came, morning came, 8 days. You know, this is the word of the book of Genesis. Evening came, morning came. God is creating everything. In Jesus Christ, the 8th day of creation, it means that Jesus is completing what God started to do. Following Jesus, our life finds fulfillment, finds salvation, and it is easy to follow. We thank God that we have this grace. To be Christian sometimes seems very difficult. We don't know what to do, we don't know how to do it, we need wisdom, but in the end, what we have to do is to follow Christ.